So, welcome to this third and maybe last part of the of my project of painting this cryptora. This, as I said, it's a beginner's project, so I might do a lot of errors. But the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to touch up on the lighter spots with the snuggling green. And let's see how well it blends into this color. I was kind of hoping that the highlight could be done partly with this rotting flesh, because it's just a tad lighter in the color. I'll just add a small amount of water to it. Just to be able to soften it up a bit. Hopefully. So we'll continue with the rotting flesh highlight on the very tip of the skin.
Thank you.
then I'll try to dry brush the tombstone with focus cream. And I'll see if I can highlight it a little bit. And maybe also some of the hair on the backside of the face. I'll just touch some add some matte white to the very top of the tombstone, mixed with a probably a little bit of gray. And now I'm gonna paint the base with some black, or close to black, heavy charcoal. I'm just gonna apply it to the entire base all the way around. Base is black. I will just make sure that it gets black into all the crevices by using a black wash on the on some of the white dots that I can see. So we'll just wait a second and leave it to dry, and I will I think I'll paint the teeth. And I guess I'll paint the teeth with the... I think I'll paint it with the... Sorry, about the shine. Push up the bone. So that's the mouth, and I think we are going to do the eyes in a red color, but it's not going to be this red because it's far too red. So I was thinking maybe corn red for the eyes. Yeah. So for the take some back impression. You can try to see the difference between the dirty, bloody side against the other side. I know I did the bones, but at the bones I did, but the back side is not done yet, and I think it needs to be looked like this. So we'll take the base and paint it with some graveyard earth around the bottom and on the top of it. I'll just give the area around the edge one more time. I'll try to on the base put a little bit of sandwich dust just to highlight it. As you can see, I made the base a little lighter with the stone, and I'm actually going to do it a bit more lighter if I can with maybe with the carrot stone, just to touch it up a bit more. So we're just going to give it some static grass. Yep. I'm going to use this one. The static grass is very green. This, as you can see, I'll put it up to this. This is the grass up close, which is going to be put mainly on the inner part of the base, but also maybe along a line of the edge, I think. Yeah. So with that, I'm just going to use some PVA glue. I'm going to use is also a very, very old brush, a rune brush of some sort. Okay, I'll try with this one. It's a very unusual brush. What I'll do is I'll just dip some glue in on the base and maybe around here, and let's see if I can get it off the ticker tape. There you go, and I'll just put some glue on it. I'll just put some glue in here, mainly because I noticed that the coverage of the color was the most poorest there. And then I'll just make some patches glue here, and maybe something. So now I'll dip it in the sorry, you can see this. Let's see if I have another old brush like this. It's not good to use that one because the one I just used is still wet and it's partly filled with glue, so I'll take another one, the greenish, and I'll just remove some of the hair. Hair, right, of course. So this is this more or less what I have intended to do with this cryptor for now. My painting skills are not that good, so when I learn some new tricks I might come back to it and do some more stuff with it. But oh, maybe we should try this one. Yeah, let's try something fun. You see, I just a while back I bought this blood for the blood gun, and maybe we could give it some blood around the around the bone. Yeah, I think we'll try that. Just to kind of freshen up some of the look, it a bit more gory. I have no idea how this is going to be. It's not much I'm just applying, I'm just, you know, very thin line to represent the blood that's actually visible once the skin retracts from the bone. This is just a line of blood along the edge of the bone. And then a little bit around the bones and the so that's, as you can see, the bone added a nice gory effect to the areas where the bone is actually sticking out. I don't know, it's very hard to see on the on this camera, but it has the blood for the blood clot has a nice wet effect, a wet look, so it's always like fresh blood. Yeah. So I'm happy, so I hope you find it amusing to see the process of a beginner trying to paint something. It took around 3 hours to paint this one, a little bit more. So, hope you had fun. Bye.